Jack and his brothers, Will and Tom, they didn't get along much. Guess on account of Jack was the baby of the clan, and well, he's his mama's pick of the litter. Them older boys were just jealous of Jack. Sometimes they was pretty hard on Jack, because they thought he was mighty soft. One day their pa decided it was time for the three of them to get out and see the world, see if they could make it. He gave all three of them round about $20, and you know, back in that day, that was a bankroll. And he told them, he said, in a year's time to come back home, and then they'd see who done the best in that year. Now Tom and Will, they went on into town and bought them some good suits, some clothes that was fit for a traveling, but young Jack, he didn't want to spend his money on clothes. He was a figuring might be something a little bit more important down the road. Tom and Will, they didn't want Jack tagging along with them either. You're too young and you're ragged and dirty. We don't want you seen with us. We'll never get a job if people sees you tagging along. But Jack insisted, and there wasn't no stopping him. Now they all set out with their mama crying behind her apron, their papa leaning on his hoe, waving them on. Now what their parents didn't know, Tom and Will, they had it planned out. They was going to do Jack out of his $20. Now they didn't let on until they was plumb away from that part of the country, far away where nobody knew them. And it happened when they came to a crossroad. Two branches of the road went different directions. Now Tom and Will, they tore right into Jack and roughed him up good. They took his money and they split it. They rode old Jack over in the swamp and left him for dead. They said nobody will ever know what happened to him. Then Tom, he headed down the left fork, and Will went down the right, and they set out to see if they could find their fortunes. Now the mud in the swamp, it healed Jack up and it brought him back to life. Jack came around to himself. Now he was bruised up, but he felt mad. He got to thinking about what he's going to do next. He thought, well, I ain't too far from home, and he could just went on back home. But Jack, he wasn't going to give up. He decided he was going to go on even without no money. He threw his old hat up in the air and see which road it would land on. It landed right square dab in the middle. So Jack went straight ahead and traveled. That wasn't much of a road, and them old bats was a-flying over his head, and an old owl started a-moaning. That's when Jack caught sight of a house off the road. It was all covered in briars and vines, and needless to say, it was a big fine house. Jack all ragged and dirty. Now he hated to call out, but he was awful tired. He was needing a place to stay for tonight, so he went on up, and only life he saw was a big old calico cat. The cat was chasing her tail around and around. Jack called out, "Hello, anybody home?" "Just a cat and a mouse," said the cat, looking right at him. "Hey, buddy," Jack said, "I've done came in the neck of the woods where cats can talk." "Well, I haven't always been a cat. There's an ugly old witch around here, and she's got my whole family. This here little mouse is my sister. Witch turned her into a cat first, then a mouse. She's coming back in 3 days, and I reckon she plans on doing the same thing to me. Well, that ain't a bit right, Jack said. Anything I can do to help you? Well, it's too late for my sister, said the cat, but you could help me turn back if you want to start tonight. Well, the cat and mouse, they showed Jack where he could get a little food and a little rest. Told Jack what he had to do. Now tonight, that witch is going to send all sorts of big old animals and bars and painters and such. And you'll have to fight them. That way that they can't come in. And if you can whoop them, well, we'll all be safe for one more night. Well, Jack, he found a big old club out by the smokehouse. He sat and waited by the door. Now, he was tired and sore for being beat up, but Jack, he is the type of feller. He could get a new wind when he was aimed to. And that was a good thing, because as soon as dark come and the moon got behind the cloud, bunch of big old mean critters came in at him from every side. There were bars and alligators and painters. Jack couldn't see what else, but they all had shiny teeth and eyes, and they all was a growling and a spitting. Anyhow, Jack made it through the night, but when the light came, there wasn't hiding or hair of any of the beasts that he had fought during the night. And the little calico cat came out, but she was a mite bigger now, and she was starting to look kind of like a girl. Well, you've done it, Jack. I knowed you could do it. Now come on in and get you some food and rest. I know that witch is seeing them middle-sized animals in here tonight, and you'll have to whoop them too. And sure enough, with the black night, the attack began. This time it's bobcats and weasels and skunks and badgers. And who knows what other demons Jack fought, but he whooped them off again. This time when the cat came out, Jack could see she was really a girl. She still had a few whiskers and claws. Her ears were still a mite pointed, but he could tell she's a girl. Jack, tonight you'll have to fight them little critters, several of them. Poison. Some of them, they can sting you to death, so you best be ready, the cat girl said. Well, Jack, he set out and he carved him some paddles and swats so as he'd be ready for this lot. And you wouldn't have known how many little fierce things are still out at night on the cat girl's porch. Jack had to fight them off. There's snakes and spiders, vampire bats and hornets. There was even a centipede, and it was plumb near big as Jack's shoe. Jack, he fought and stomped and swatted and smacked all night long. And by the time the sun come up, he'd run plumb out of steam. Well, not until the door swung open. There stood the prettiest red-haired girl Jack had ever seen in all his life. You done it, Jack. Now I'm Kathy again instead of cat girl. Come on in, I'll fix you some grub tonight. There's only that old witch yourself to deal with now, Jack. And one thing you have to know is not let her help you do anything, or she'll try. But if you let her, she'll change you and me, both of us, into cats. And then there won't be no way of saving any of us. We'll end up mice like my poor sister. Well, Jack, he stretched out and got some rest. And toward the evening, he got ready for the fight. He sat down by the hearth, taking a needle and thread. He set into putting patches on his old coat. Well, pretty soon there was a blowing and a howling, like a bad storm was on the way. A big old wind blew the door open, and then came that old witch. There's lots of witches in the world. There's pretty ones, good ones, bad ones. But this one was a witch of the world. Nobody was ever as ugly and mean as that old hag standing before Jack. She had the kind of face that could just plumb sour milk. "Howdy, Jack." "So we meet," she said, stretching her old claws out towards the fire. Now Jack's stomach turned, but he didn't let on. "Howdy, ma'am." "What the devil are you doing, boy?" Twisting that jacket up in knots. "Here, let me fix it for you." "I'll do my own mending, thank you," Jack told her, kind of stiff-like. Well, Jack, he finished mending his old jacket. He put it back on. He set out to making a little corn pone. "I just can't stand seeing a man dabbling around with food. Let me do it for you," she said. "I'll fix my own," Jack said. He finished mixing them up. He set them over on the fire. And he went and got him a skillet and put a little bacon in it to fry it. Well, Jack turned around for a second, and the witch picked up a fork and was going to try and flip Jack's bacon. He saw her out of the corner of his eye, and he flew at her. And he was a-moving so fast, he knocked her right in the fire. Boy, well, then there was such a crackling and a sparkling and exploding like you ain't never seen in your life, until there was nothing left of the old witch except a nasty old smell of sulfur. Well, Kathy, she came in out of her hiding place and give Jack a big old smooch. "You done it, Jack. We got plumb shed of that old witch." That next morning when it got light, Kathy took Jack out and showed him around the farm. All them brambles and bushes was gone. And the pasture, it was plumb full of horses and cows and sheep. These chickens are pecking around the yard. All the orchards was plumb full of fruit. And they was a strong box, plumb full of gold. Kathy's people had been real rich farmers before the witch come. Jack, he looked around. He saw all that was around. His heart kind of sunk. "I've been thinking I'd like to ask you to marry, but I'm just a poor boy. You have all this land and livestock and money, Kathy." Well, she threw her head back. And she just laughed. And she said, "Well, you saved it all from that witch and my life. You're brave. You're the bravest man I've ever met. And us to get hitched up, well, that's a wonderful idea." So they hooked up an old wagon and a pair of big fine horses, and they went off. They got Jack a big fine suit, and they come across the preacher to marry him. Well, they got married, they went on back so they could mind the farm. Now, Jack and Kathy, they was good. They was good helpmates for each other. She could cook and sew. Jack, he knew how to plow and plant. They had gobs of money for whatever they wanted. But Jack, you know, he was watching the calendar. And he knew that year was about up. The day was a-coming for him to return home. When it finally come, he hitched up that old fine carriage. He put his old raggedy clothes under the seat. He set off with Kathy to his home place. When they got to the fork in the road, Jack told Kathy what had happened. She was pretty mad at his brothers, but Jack made her promise not to tell. So when they got to the last curve in the road, Jack stopped the wagon. He put his old raggedy clothes on, messed up his hair, rubbed some dirt on his face. He said, "Wait here for me, and I'll just go and see what's happened while I've been gone." As he come up the road, Jack's pap saw him coming, and he is right glad. "Looks like you ain't done too well. Let me go grab you some of my clothes so you don't look so raggedy." "No, pap, I reckon I'll just go as I am," Now his mama was sure right glad to see him. She hugged his neck, and his brothers looked at him kind of sheepish, like they was wondering if he was going to tell on them. But they couldn't help but being a little smart-alecky, because he had all them old clothes, and they had on nice clothes and some pretty wives. Now folks that do stuff like that and treat you wrong, sometimes just act that way. Well, Jack, he visited with them for a while. Then he said, "I've left some things at my camp up in the woods, and I'll be back directly." Well, Jack, he ran back to where Kathy was and washed off his face in a stream. He put on his nice fine suit and hat. And they drove clippity-clap right up to Jack's house with all that fine harness and a shining and a jingling. His papa heard them coming, and he looked out. Now, who can that be, do you reckon? "Must be somebody rich. Ain't no one around here has a buggy like it," Tom said. Jack's ma looked out. "Well, I declare, that's Jack. But who's that beautiful girl in that fine dress and bonnet?" Tom told his wife, "You hide under the bed." And Will said to his'n, "You go hide yourself in the attic. Can't let them see you in that old cotton dress." So Tom's wife, she hid under the bed. Will's wife, she crawled up in the attic. Jack and Kathy came in. Jack introduced them to his ma and pa and his brothers. They talked for a bit. Kathy, she looked around. "Tom and Will," she said, "Jack told me you two had wives, but I don't reckon I see them. Are you going to introduce us?" Well, there was nothing for them to do but call their wives. Both girls was covered with dust and feathers and spider webs, and they looked worse than they did before. "Well, you men ought to be ashamed," Kathy told them. "You just don't know how to treat a lady." The girls, they could tell right away they was going to like Kathy all right. That night they threw a big old party. They had some of their ma's good fried chicken and mashed taters and greens and a little pumpkin pie. And all the boys, they talked about their adventures, but there wasn't no question about who had done the best. The next day, Jack took his pap and his ma back up to the big old farmhouse. And, well, as far as I know, they all lived happy. But I reckon Tom and Will, I don't reckon they ever did amount to much.